unreal. I stopped to take pictures of the fall, and this knucklehead, she's already got a largemouth on, and it's a good one. You knucklehead, look at that.
First cast.
Not bad, kiddo. Molly. All right. Kelly here is kicking my ass 2-1. 2-0, actually. 2-0. Let's get it straight. First of the day. Little Archie. That little chunk. Looks like it. Yep. Nice little chunk. Good little creek fish. I just took your cue. Started using a jerkbait. You figured the pattern out every single time out here. Look at this pretty little. Thank you. fish. Yeah. Let's see what you got. Yeah. Well, it's fun. That's beautiful. Big one. Huge. We've got this little rapalotide on this morning. It is doing some really good stuff. I'm gonna throw some of my stuff here in a little bit, but for now, don't change what's working for you. So, let's see what else we can get. Alright, so, just to give you an idea of what I was using to catch the first three. Kelly is also using a jerkbait, but she's using like a shad pattern, a white with yellow stripe, a light blue back, and the shad dot on the side. This has got a little bit more flash on the side of it. It mimics a perch or a common creek minnow. You can see we're kind of fishing where the creek merges with the Spring River. Got just a little bit of flash on the tail, and this is very effective. It's a small presentation. We're going to change it up. Now we're going to go, let's see, where is it? We're going to go with Jekyll bait, Pipsqueak. I brought a couple of them along with me. And I also have a shad pattern, but I'm going to start out with a random baby bass pattern. Lightweight, size 8 and 10 hooks respectively, 8 in the front, 10 in the back. And we're going to tie this on. And the reason that I'm comfortable using some hard baits here is that we've got some really good current and some good seams in here. And then we've got these eddies, if you can look out here. These eddies are swirling right behind these riffles and seams, so that's primarily where we've been targeting this morning, and it's landed us about half a dozen large and smallmouth so far. I think both of our biggest ones were largemouth. Kelly caught one on her first cast, which is awesome. Sometimes it's a jinx, but that hasn't held true today. She's consistently caught. There's lots of fish rising to the top. I'm going to throw this little guy on and see what we can do with it. Here comes a pipsqueak.
You're still running?
Walking with the Father, talking with the Son. If you have a real strong current like this, and you don't have a lot of weight, or you have a small bait, one thing that helps get that bait down there, if you're using a tiny little crankbait, a mini like this, is if you actually stick your rod tip under the water, that bait's going to hunt deeper. And that can make a tremendous amount of difference when you're in a current like this. Hey, looks like a monster on that. That's decent.
Baby, call a
very
number.
Nice.
Nobody left it in town.
Very nice. Yeah.
Baby, paint skulls and constellations on the ground.
Less than pound problem.
she laid me gently. She laid me slow. Somebody is saving up there. On the street.
It wanted it though. It's a good hook set right in the corner of the mouth where it's supposed to be. The bait looks great. That's a great suspense. I like that. Slow rise.
Talking with the spine.
Wow.
Mama sing, open up yourself when worlds align. My secret Jesus. Good bread broke. On blood and tenor.
Oh! I bet you this is the reaction I've been waiting for. Of course, half the battle's getting in the bag. Come on, Alex, this is impossible. Love your new packaging.